Hi, I'm Chris Carter. I'm a tutor at Point Blank. I'm a programmer, producer, mixer, engineer, DJ, sound designer. I just remember sitting on the floor with this box lid record player. You didn't call it a turntable or a deck, you know, that I think had been my mum's before she got married or something, and I kind of got my hands on it. I just had this big pile of 7-inch records that I used to, I mean, they're all knackered, obviously, out of their sleeves and scratched up and so on, but I was just kind of a bit obsessed with it, and they just used to be kind of leave me alone for hours, just sat on the floor with this thing in front of me, kind of watching and listening to it. So I don't know how old I was, but I know that I couldn't read what was written on the labels, but I could identify them by the different designs on the labels and stuff like that. So, well, I started playing instruments when I was a kid, like playing a guitar, playing drums. I got my first little mono synth when I was about 12, like this little tiny Yamaha thing. But it was quite slow progress with the electronic side of things. I was working in studios as a assistant, then as an engineer. Gradually started doing my own things. I had an MPC, I kind of learnt to make music just on an MPC. Finally got myself a Mac and Logic, and it was kind of quite slow, steady progress over quite a number of years. I didn't actually put any tunes of my own out until I was, I think it was 26. So it's quite a slow, quite a late developer. I've never been specifically focused on one kind of music, which can actually be quite a hindrance, I think, because it can be very good to specialise, but it can also be quite good to have a broad scope. But I've kind of never ruled anything out, and I'll listen to everything, because I think it's all got something that you can take from it, you know. Most of what I do now is specifically kind of production music or library music or music which is made to a brief, music which is made for a company, a library or a production house, and they will have a certain type of music or style that they want, and they'll give you a brief and I'll kind of work to that. It's real benefit personally to be able to help other people. I like to think of it as a two-way thing, rather than just you've got the tutor here and the students there, and it's all one way. You know, it's quite good to have some kind of interaction. Everybody learns from it, I think. I would say that generally people find it all interesting. You do find some people drawn a little bit more to one technique or one instrument or something, but what I really try and do is say to people, don't just look for the bits that you thought you wanted before you came here. Take it all, you know, it's all really, really useful. You can use all of this, and generally people do, which is a good thing. To learn all this stuff so quickly just wasn't there when I was learning, wasn't really possible. But I understand the impatience of people just wanting to learn, and I remember that frustration of sitting down in front of something, turning all these knobs and going, what, that doesn't do anything. You know, it's kind of, you've got these ideas, you just want to be able to get those ideas out. And they just want to be able to progress quickly. And they do, you know, we help them to do that, definitely. Success is about having an idea and having some results, but it's what you do with them afterwards. Obviously, it's not quite enough to just have something which is really, really good, but not know how to share it or show it to other people. So I think there'll be lots of other areas of the course that help people to be able to do that really well. Sound design, it's more about specifically helping people at the idea stage achieve the results that they're trying to get. Then they'll be able to take those on and know what to do with them.